My name's Tom Loveland. I'm a researcher with the U.S. Geological Survey's Aero Center, and I'm involved in land use and land cover change research. My work over the years have been involved in trying to use remote sensing to map and monitor land cover and land cover change, and I've been doing that primarily over large areas, states to nations to the globe. Land cover maps are a fundamental geospatial input for a wide range of environmental, economic, and other types of investigations on the impacts between human activity and the environment. It's also important to have a fundamental knowledge of what the land is made of and how it's changing and why it's changing. And so my work has contributed to a number of those areas. I think it's important to realize that the USGS put a lot of preparation into the applications of Landsat data prior to the launch of the first satellite, and around that time started investing in the capabilities to use remotely sensed data, and especially Landsat, for studying and mapping land cover. And over the years, we have continually changed and innovated our approach to it, increased the frequency of products, improved their accuracy, and expanded the applications. And so, you know, the USGS plays a pretty critical role in meeting the national need for land cover. And it's all because of the ability to use the Landsat record so effectively. When Landsat was conceived, its mission objective was to understand the condition of the planet and to be able to distinguish between natural and human change. And so mapping land cover was a natural core part of Landsat's mission, and over the years it's contributed to that. By having that synoptic view of the planet, we're able to document change rates from place to place, from Landsat pixel to pixel. And when we do that over large areas, we see that some areas of our world are changing constantly and others are relatively stable. And so simply being able to identify those regions is something that Landsat's uniquely qualified to do. The Landsat Science Team represents a window on the Landsat user community. And as such, they provide a great deal of insight and intelligence on how Landsat data are used, what the limitations are, and the changes that may come about. For instance, they provided a lot of the early advocacy in making Landsat data available to users worldwide at no cost. They argued in favor of something called the Landsat Global Archive Consolidation Initiative, in which we have essentially, at the USGS, been rescuing historical Landsat data scattered around the world at current and former ground stations. All changes are local. When we're looking at land use or land cover, it's the accumulation of a number of local decisions that end up having impacts both locally, regionally, and ultimately at the global level. And because Landsat is so synoptic, we have the ability to start looking at both the causes and the consequences of land change from that local to global scale.